the TIF district encompasses a certain geographic area, the east end of downtown, goes as far west, south, First Avenue South, and takes in the Tropicana Field site up to 16th Street. The TIF district was created in 1981 and 1982. It showed a total ad valorem value for the district at that time of $108 million. It's grown to around $900 million over the last, well, since 1982. But what happens when you establish a district, you set that base, which we set the base at $108 million. Any incremental increase in the taxable value of the property from year to year goes into the trust fund for the tax increment financing trust fund. That increase in values, and it's the city's share and the county's share. By law, it can't include the school district or any special taxing districts at the PPC or SWIFT money or any of them. So the incremental increase in value for the property tax base in that geographic area is available to fund projects, either on a pay-as-you-go, if they're small-scale projects, or through bond financing, if they're large, like Tropicana Field or the Peter or Mahaffey Field. That's how the process works.
Okay. Thank you very much.
It's Fred Raley. Let me say something to that. In the event that that was not created, all that incremental fund would be in the general funds of both the county and the city. So basically, it kind of freezes the tax value of those properties back in 1983, where everybody else's taxes get increased and put into the general fund. So it really comes out of the general fund. Isn't that correct?
That's not correct. The city, it doesn't affect the individual property owner. Their taxes are what they are based on millage. What it does do is the revenue stream from the city and county's general fund is allocated, the increase is allocated to do improvement projects in that district. And according to the current in-town redevelopment plan I mentioned earlier, and the interlocal agreement between the city and county, those two documents provide that the district will be in place through 2035, unless the city council should decide in the future to sunset the plan and terminate the interlocal agreement early. But no, it doesn't affect the individual property owners. You are paying what you're going to pay. It just affects where the incremental increase in the ad valorem tax revenues go, and they go into the trust fund.
Okay, now let me just try this again because it's a complicated issue. We have studied it extensively, and we basically think that the city is improperly presenting this. If there was not that district, wouldn't all those funds that are going to, let's say, be used to appear, wouldn't they be in the general funds like everybody else's?
Fred?
Yes or no?
I don't think you could hear that entirely.
Just say the end again.
Okay. If there was not a tax, if there was not a taxing entity set up like that, where they basically all the increase in the value went to a special project, wouldn't their taxes go to the general funds of both the city and the county like everybody else's?
If there was no tax increment financing district, then yes, the income stream, the increase in property value taxes would go into the respective general funds of the city and county. But the reason the district was created, because
has there been any increase in the cost to the city or the county since 1983 that other people are going to have to bear the brunt of paying those increases because the people within the TIF do not, because their increases in value go to this special project?